Hello everyone, good morning. I'm jumping in here and I want to talk to you about anxiety and your gut. And I want to help you understand exactly what you're feeling right now. Because if you are struggling with gut issues and anxiety, there's a real distinct experience that you go through on a day-to-day basis that really no one else understands unless they're going through it with you. And when I was going through this myself, it felt really frustrating. It also felt extremely lonely and exhausting, quite frankly. And so helping you understand this process and how you can work better within it is going to bring you so much relief. And so I'm going to teach you the tools that I implemented when working with anxiety and gut health and what I teach my clients inside the Love and Trust Your Guts program. So first of all, I want you to understand that anxiety is definitely a state of overwhelm, and it's multifactorial, meaning there's many, many different things that are going to contribute to its cause, right? The reason why it's happening in the first place. But I'm going to talk about three really big hitters today that cause anxiety, and especially when you have gut issues going on. So the very first thing that we need to be working with when we have anxiety is heavy metals. Oftentimes there are toxic levels of heavy metals inside our bodies. And this is why we need to make sure drainage pathways are open in our body. Okay, so drainage pathways are like the pipelines in our body that we send toxins through to be eliminated. And part of the problem is when we have gut issues, but also when we just have a lifetime of wear and tear on our guts, our pipelines become clogged up and your body has a hard time eliminating toxins. And so heavy metals are one of the toxins that can start to accumulate and collect in the body. And they'll deposit, there's a fluff flying in my face, they will deposit in places like our brain and can really begin to impact our mental health. And so a lot of the times when we have gut issues, our doctors will say things like, "You're just stressed." Right? Has anyone ever told you that before? Have you ever been told that your gut issues are a stress issue? They're just in your head? I want you to know that I believe everything that you are feeling, and this is not just in your head. Anxiety is not just emotions. It's not just an emotional imbalance. It can be a very real physical imbalance. Okay, so that also means that you can be empowered and know that there is something that you can work with there, that it's not just you being emotional or hormonal. As women, we get told this all the time, "Oh, you're just being hormonal." No, there can be physical imbalances. So heavy metals are a really big contributing factor. Personally, when I was in the thick of recovering from mold toxins, toxic mold exposure from our apartment from last year, and Lyme over the last year, these two things, anxiety was a very, very real issue that came up for me. And it was interesting because I hadn't felt it in a lot of years. I'd done a lot of work and worked through a lot of emotional stuff. But I got to then experience firsthand what physical imbalances were happening in my body that created this anxiety. So outside of the mold and the Lyme and other, you know, things I was dealing with, I also had really high levels of aluminum that my body was trying to eliminate. This came from growing up in a household where my parents used aluminum foil. They still do on everything. And every time I see them, I'm like, "Throw that shit out. You gotta switch to parchment paper." And parchment paper is the bomb, by the way, because nothing sticks to it and everything sticks to aluminum foil. So anyways, my parents wrap everything in aluminum foil, cook it on the barbecue, etc. And this is one of the reasons why I had really high levels of aluminum, but also just years of using non-natural deodorants. Deodorants are loaded with things like aluminum. And so we get exposed from whether it be products that we put in on our bodies, to the things that we're cooking with, the tools like pots, pans, and things that we're cooking with, to even tap water, to, oh my goodness, if I was going to say vaccine, should I say that out loud? not all, but some. It's just, it's everywhere. We get exposed to heavy metals everywhere. And so we really want to be cleaning that up and making sure your drains, your pipeline is open so your body can send those excess heavy metals out, okay? So heavy metals can impact our mental health. The second thing is mold. Oh man, does mold ever do this? Mold really disrupts our brain. And this is why people who have mold exposure have really debilitating fatigue, brain fog, and memory loss. It got to the point where I was really struggling to remember names. I was struggling to remember what I had eaten for breakfast. I was struggling to remember tasks. And I started writing, like, I write everything down because I couldn't forget things. I needed to remember things. And my team was such a blessing through the last year and really helping support me in remembering things. So I love them to pieces for that. But this is a classic example of how mold will disrupt our brain pathways. And this can really impact what we call our glymphatic system. And this is like your brain drain. So your brain will drain into your lymphatic system and starts flushing toxins out. But when we have mold exposure, this really gets bunged up and we end up with this real imbalance going on. So anxiety, and not just anxiety, but also depression can present when there's been mold exposure. And this is one of the big things that we go looking for when we have a client that starts with us who has been given multiple medications to manage their anxiety or depression and is not seeing any sort of improvements. This is when we start going on the hunt for mold. And 9 times out of 10, they're actually living in a moldy home and they didn't know it, or they're working in a moldy environment, and or they've had a previous exposure to mold and they thought everything was good, but they're actually being re-exposed somewhere in their environment. So this is a really important one that needs to be recognized, often goes under the radar, and mold is a really tricky one because we can't always see it visibly with our eyes. So again, guys, anxiety and depression isn't something that's just in our head. It doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with you. Sometimes there's something environmental that is actually impacting your health. And the way that this felt for me when I was living in our moldy home before was I was having like night terrors, I was having nightmares, really struggling to sleep. I even would wake up in the morning and immediately had to go into managing my anxiety. And it was, you know, I'd wake up and it felt like I was like looking for the anxiety, like, where are you? You always come. And I often had to start with a hot bath to try to calm myself right from get-go. Before I even started my day, I was in my anxiety management tools. So it's something that feels like it's happening to you. And this is where I want you guys to, again, if there's one thing you take away from this today, please understand that it is not just in your head. What you're experiencing is very real. Okay, so the third thing that we have to touch on when we're talking about anxiety and your gut are the stealth infections that can also present. Stealth infections can range from parasites to mold to Lyme, but parasites being one really common one that can really wreak havoc. And a lot of times people think that parasites only reside in the intestines, when in fact they can live all throughout your body, in your brain, in your eyes. We get eye floaters, ringing ears or dizziness. They can be in the ears. They can be in the nose. They can be in your gut, obviously. They can be in your liver and bile ducts. They can be all throughout your body. And this is often a root causative factor behind many of the digestive symptoms that you are experiencing. So these are some common things that we need to go explore, not just from a healing your gut standpoint, but also from a looking to resolve the anxiety and depression you may be experiencing alongside this. When we put, you know, these root causative factors even to the side, we also just have to acknowledge how stressful it can be, how lonely it can be when you feel so sick. When it feels like you can't eat anything and you feel like you can't participate in family functions, or it's even impacting your relationship with your spouse. You know, being intimate is really hard to do when you don't feel good in your body. And so I wanted to bring one of the main teachings that I bring to our clients in the Love and Trust Your Guts program to you guys today. And I wanna help you understand what your window of tolerance is. So window of tolerance is like this safe bubble that your body feels comfortable in. You can also think about it kind of like a comfort zone, but it's more complex than just your comfort zone. So we call it your window of tolerance. And basically what this is anything that not just you emotionally can tolerate, but your body can physically tolerate, your nervous system. And if you find that you feel extra irritable or you're a little snappy with your family or your kids, or even have light sensitivity or sound sensitivity, if you find that just your environment feels really fucking stressful. I always described it, again, my personal experience with this, it felt like I was like, had some like screamo band like going on in my head constantly, like, and I wanted to just like crawl out of my body, but I couldn't. When I was outside of my window of tolerance, that was a sensation for me personally. Super stressed, super irritable, super like, I need to get the hell out of here. And this was a sign that I had breached my window of tolerance. Okay, so when we're working with your window of tolerance, what I want you to imagine is it's okay for you to play around the line, right? We want to expand your window of tolerance so that you're able to go to work and function, so that you're able to be around your family or have music, you know, if your spouse is watching or your kids are watching TV in the background, that noise isn't stressing you out. Or the idea of going out in public isn't stressing you out. We want to expand that window of tolerance, but what we don't want to do is jump too far out. Okay, so we just want to like step over the line and teach your body it's safe. And then your body expands its window of tolerance and your body's gonna be like, okay, good, we're good, we're safe. We can keep going. And then you go back into the window of tolerance, take good care of yourself. Okay, if you jump too far outside the window of tolerance, you're done. You're gonna feel super exhausted. You're gonna feel absolutely maxed out for the day. You've reached your capacity and some, and you're gonna feel like you cannot function the rest of the day. So I'm gonna give you some real life examples that I've personally experienced when playing with my window of tolerance. When I was detoxing from the mold and Lyme and all the things over the last year, there were periods where my body's window of tolerance became very small. And I want you to understand why your body's feeling this way. When you have all these infections going on, your body is working really hard for you. It has your back. It's working really hard to keep you upright, to keep you alive and well. And so that means that it doesn't have a lot of energy to expel on things around you, like day-to-day tasks, certain things that you used to be able to do, you might feel like you can't do anymore. It's just temporary. It's just your body saying, hey, listen, I have less capacity, less tolerance for these other things because I'm busy trying to hold down the fort. Right? I'm busy trying to keep this body functioning. So there were periods where I remember there was one day, my sister and I, we decided to take my grandma to this local farm. It was strawberry season. So we were going to go pick up some fresh strawberries. And we literally just went, picked up my grandma, went to the farm, grabbed the strawberries and took her home. And by the time I dropped her off, I was done. I was done. I didn't have any capacity that day. I didn't realize that until I was like mid-process of this strawberry situation that this was not working for me that day. And the conversations were totally pleasant. My grandma wanted to just chit-chat, right? But I didn't have the capacity to chit-chat. And so going strawberry picking put me way outside my window of tolerance. I got home by 11 o'clock in the morning and I was done for the rest of the day. There's some days where you might even feel like you need to nap, and that's okay. That's a sign you've maxed your window of tolerance. So I share this example with you because I want you to understand that it doesn't mean that we have to have anything particularly traumatic happen to us. It's just that your body is at capacity. And it's important that we don't judge what's coming up. Judge what is stressing our body. To judge, oh my goodness, your grandma? Get it together, Alyssa. It's just your grandma, right? We don't want to get into this guilt tripping. No. We just accept where we're at so that we can hold more space for healing. And this concept of window of tolerance is so important for your healing, because what I see many people doing is they are crossing their window of tolerance while trying to keep the people around them happy. They're saying yes when they want to say no because they don't want to let people down. But every time you say yes when you want to say no, or you push yourself too far outside your window of tolerance, and you activate your nervous system, and your nervous system shuts down rest and digest and goes into fight or flight, well, now you're done for the day. Now we're actually costing you your healing. It's actually going to damage the gut. And so it's far too expensive. Do you see what I'm saying here? It's far too expensive for you to continue pushing yourself outside your window of tolerance. So be okay with it being 10 a.m., you just woke up not too long ago, and you feel like you need to go back to bed, right? Be okay with not, you know, having had plans, let's say you had plans to go out to dinner with some friends, and realizing you don't want to go. Be okay with canceling those plans, right?